Hello guys, welcome to For Collector channel. Check out this video. This short clip was created using Deforum on Google Colab Notebook. Stable Diffusion is an open source AI program for image generation. Within Stable Diffusion, there is an extension called Deforum, which is another open source for video generation. Stable Diffusion can be downloaded on your computer and you can run it using a popular user interface like Automatic 1111, but it requires a powerful computer with decent NVIDIA graphics card and generous VRAM or video RAM. I have a basic computer, so it doesn't have the computing power necessary to run this program. So instead, I use a free cloud service provided by Google called Google Colab, where there is no downloads required. If you are interested, keep watching, and I will show you step by step how you too can generate AI videos on your own on the web. I am no programmer and certainly not very techie, so I will keep it simple, so follow along. We will first use this link, which is also included in the description, to get to the Google Colab Notebook page. First click on File and then click Save a Copy in Drive. This will open a duplicate tab for a private and secure session. It will say Copy of Deforum. And if you wish, you can rename it, but this is totally optional and you don't have to do this. Next, we will click on Runtime and then click on Change Runtime Type to make sure T4 GPU is selected and then click Save. Now we will click on launch icon next to NVIDIA GPU to launch this code. This will activate cloud-based GPU or graphics processing unit for our session. Some steps will be quick while others will take some time, so be patient. When the command execution is successfully completed, you will see a small green check mark, which means we can advance to the next step. Next is environment setup, which will launch PyTorch, Xformers, etc., basically all the code for virtual environment and neural network in Python programming language. Path setup is next. This will ask us to connect and allow access to your own Google Drive, where temporary data will be stored and your final video will be uploaded. So click Connect to Google Drive, which will launch a pop-up window where you will enter your Gmail login and password. And then another pop-up window will open, and scroll down and click Allow to give Google Colab access to your Google Drive. Once your Google Drive is mounted and connected, we can move on to the next step. Model setup is next. Models are various pre-trained machine learning datasets which were used to train AI. These are called checkpoints or safe tensors. There are a few that are already preloaded. The two that I like the most are Protogen and version 1.5 pruned checkpoints. You can select either one of the two and you will get really good results. Then just click Run. Warning, this step will take a few minutes, so be patient. Now we are on to the settings, where we get to enter details of how we want our video to look. In the animation section, we will select 2D mode and change max frame to 100. This, along with frames per second, determines the length of our video. So if you divide 100 frames by 10 frames per second, we will get a final video 10 seconds in length. More frames would mean longer video, and also it will take longer time to generate. I suggest choosing 100 to 200 frames. For border, keep it on replicate, which avoids artifactual lines on the edges of the video. You can play around with zoom. If you want no zoom, choose 1.0. Numbers greater than 1.0 would allow camera to zoom in, while number less than 1.0 would allow camera to zoom out. For example, zoom of 1.1 would mean zoom in 10% speed, and zoom of 0.9 would mean zoom out in 10% speed. Translation, X and Y, allows us to shift the scene to left or right by changing X settings, or shift the scene up or down by changing Y settings. I will change it to 0 for no camera shifting or translation. Other settings for rotation are used in 3D mode, so we will ignore them. Nothing else needs to be changed, so let us run this code. Next is the prompt code. Prompt is written instructions to tell Deforum what you want to see in your video and when. Let's delete all the text in green. Now, I will show you how you can set up different scenes in your 100 frame video. This is the basic format of the prompt. Pay attention to the colons, quotations, and even commas, which if missing, it will give you an error. Since I am a banknote collector and love the engravings on old banknotes, I will write prompts so that the program will create engraving style images. For initial frame 0, I want to start with a White House engraving. Then, at frame number 20, I want to transition to the Capitol building and so on. Also, I will specify what I don't want to see in the negative prompt section. Next, specify some final settings before we can start generating the video. If you plan to upload an initial image for your video, use the same size settings as your image. I will specify 768 by 512 for the video size. You can use portrait mode by choosing 512 by 768 instead of just keep it as a square video, 512 by 512. For sampler, which is basically an algorithm to create a quality image by repetitively removing noise, I prefer DPM2, so let's pick that. Keep steps between 50 to 100. Keep scale between 7 to 14 so that the video generation closely follows your prompts. Lower than 7 would ignore your prompts. Keep seed behavior to iterative. Using initial image is optional but recommended. Check use initial and keep the strength between 0.65 to 0.80. So, the video actually starts off looking like the image you're provided. Click the folder tab on the left sidebar, then drag and drop your image. Click on the three dots to copy path. Now paste that path here. Click add noise and change noise level to 0.02. Now we are ready to click go and start generating our video. Now we can watch our video creation frame by frame, which will be a slow process. Our video is finished. It took around 20 minutes to create this 10-second video. It may be faster or slower for you based on your internet speed. Now let's download this video, uncheck skip, change max frames to 100, and the frames per second to 10. This will give us a 10-second final video. Now, we can download the video in MP4 format. It will also be saved in your Google Drive under folder named AI and subfolder Stable Diffusion. Once finished, don't forget to end your session by selecting Disconnect and Delete Runtime. A word of caution, don't overuse the Google Colab, otherwise they will restrict your access in the future. If you have a technical issue, please understand I am not a pro, so I may not be able to answer. If you do create a video, do leave me a message as to how easy or difficult these instructions were. If you find this useful, do share with others and spread the AI love. Peace.